Hello, I'm Michael Maynard, a software engineer on the Microsoft Graph team. Today, I'm going to briefly talk about Microsoft Graph and .NET Core and why this is an important scenario. I'll go over the OAuth 2.0 client credential flow and the scenarios where you might use it. And then, I'll go over a quick demo of using Visual Studio 2017 for Mac to create a client application that uses the client credential flow to get an access token and make calls to the Microsoft Graph. Microsoft Graph and .NET Core provide another way to make cross-platform solutions. In addition to our cross-platform client libraries such as JavaScript, Java, and PHP, you can now create .NET Microsoft Graph solutions that will run on Windows, Mac, and Linux. The cross-platform opportunity for .NET developers is supported by tools that work across these platforms. So you have Visual Studio for Windows, which you may already be familiar with, Visual Studio 2017 for Mac, and Visual Studio Code that will run on Windows, Mac, and Linux. You can create your Microsoft Graph .NET solution on any of these three major platforms using tools on those platforms that can target all three of these platforms. These scenarios are web and service and client applications. So now let's go and talk about the client credential flow for Microsoft Graph. So before we go any further, I'd like to talk about how in our demo that we are using client credential flow as a way to get a token for our client library. So first off, the client credential flow uses the identity of the application to access resources. This enables server-to-server and service scenarios. Basically, these are scenarios where a user is not directly interacting with the application. Permissions are granted to the application itself. This is instead of the application being granted permissions to access resources on behalf of a user. So an end user will never see the all-familiar dialogue because the end user is not actually making the call. The application is. And in order for the application to make these calls and get the token, a tenant admin must grant permissions. The granted permissions are for an application that will not be controlled by a user, but will be accessing user data. The tenant admin will need to trust that the application will behave as expected. In our scenario, the admin will provide the consent to the application. I'm going to demo a simple Microsoft Graph application that was created using Visual Studio 2017 for Mac. We will quickly demonstrate admin consent to give the application access to Microsoft Graph resources. We will briefly review the code and then fill out the missing information. More information about this code and how to run it yourself will be provided in a link to a repo later in this presentation. This demo application was created using Visual Studio 2017 for Mac and can be used in Visual Studio 2017 on Windows and Visual Studio Code on Windows, Mac, and Linux. This solution has a single code file. It's a .NET Core console application. I'm using console application just for demo purposes, but this could easily be a standalone service application running on Windows, Mac, or Linux. So let's review the code. This is a simple console app with a main. Here we are on line 17, getting a Graph Service Client object. And here's where we run it, where we're getting a collection of users. And then what we're going to end up doing is writing out the information about the first user, the first user's user principal name. So let's look at how we are going to authenticate this Graph Client Graph Service Client with the client credential OAuth flow. So first off, we're going to need to get a client ID. So when you register your application, you're going to get an application ID. You're going to copy that information and paste it here. Now that we have our client ID, we'll put it in here. Next, following the instructions in the linked GitHub repo, one of the steps you'll do is get a client secret or generate a password. So let's go get that password that we generated previously. Let's paste our password in. Okay, so we've got our information from our app registration. The next thing we need to do is get a hold of the tenant ID for our tenant. There's the tenant ID. Information on how to get your tenant ID will be provided in the linked repo. So now we have our URL that we are going to use to post our request to get an access token for our application. Now let's go take a look at the post body. Here we are specifying the client credentials, grant type. And in the next line, on line 45, we're specifying that we want to use the scopes that were specified in the app registration. So we're not providing any scopes here ourselves. We're just going to use the default ones that we specified when we registered our app. And on line 46, we can see that this is our post body that we're going to be using to request an access token. So here's our client ID, our scopes, our password, and our grant type. So let's create our graph client object. So in the authentication delegate, we're going to create a request message with the post verb and the token URL that we created earlier, and we'll also pass in our post body. We're going to create a client and then send our request message to get that access token. In the response body, we're going to get the access token as part of a JSON object, and then we're going to inject it into our request message. Every time a call is made to Microsoft Graph, this code is going to run and inject a token into the request so that we have an authenticated request every time. So, but before we can run this code, we need to authenticate, we actually have to give admin consent to this application to run. So let's do that next. Okay, so in order to authenticate with, to provide this application access to the Microsoft Graph resources, we need an admin to consent. So here's the basic URL structure for the client credential flow. We have to specify the tenant ID. We're going to specify this is admin consent. And then we specify the client ID here and the redirect URL that we got from our app registration. So let's do this right now. We're going to sign in with our administrator account, and then our administrator is going to carefully read these permissions and determine that they're going to accept it. Now this is going to be a redirect 404. That's because we don't have a web server running at localhost. But we know this was a success because in the redirect URL, we have admin consent equals true. So now our application is able to run and access the Microsoft Graph resources. So let's do that now. Now that we've consented this application to be able to access Microsoft Graph resources, we can run this program. Here we go. We're going to run it. It's going to open up a terminal window and specify success. The first user returned from Microsoft Graph is, and here's the UPN of that first user. So now we have the basic setup to create a headless Microsoft Graph application that you can run on Windows, Mac, or Linux. This sample shows how you can use Visual Studio for Mac 2017 to create a simple .NET Core 2.0 application that uses the Microsoft Graph client library. So for more information, you can go to dev.microsoft.com/graph to get information about samples, SDKs, and documentation. You can go to github.com/microsoft-graph for samples and all of our client libraries for Microsoft Graph. If you have questions about Microsoft Graph, go to Stack Overflow and use the Microsoft Graph tag. For more information about the demo sample in this presentation, go to github.com/MichaelMaynor/GraphNetCore2, and you can download this repo and run this code sample yourself. Thank you very much for watching, and have a great day.